In this video, I'll show you why beating hunger isn't about just eating anything, but rather actually avoiding eating the wrong stuff. And I'll even give you some concrete ideas for better snacks. If you missed my last video on when and how hunger strikes you most commonly, check it out now. I'll put a link in the description. Science shows that eating fast food creates hunger instead of fighting it. Now, this might sound a bit counterintuitive, but let me explain. Blood sugar swings are caused by sugar, fast carb loading, and low nutrient density ingredients, and these are really the main culprit for hunger and sapped energy. If you were only optimizing for instant gratification, and you weren't concerned about health or focus or motivation or anything else, which you likely are, it would be a simple question of like, hey, how can I flood my system with a mind-numbing barrage of fast carbs, regardless of the consequences, and fast food certainly gets the job done. But other than that, the facts look really, really grim. While a cheap takeout meal may feel like a budget option, fast food is not even that cheap when you look at the nutritional value of what you're actually getting. A handful of nuts and dried berries has up to 10 times the nutrients of a fast food meal, and at a fraction of the cost. It's usually not the kind of social experience that a nice meal can provide anyway, right? Like sitting down at a hot dog joint? Not that likely. So why not save the time and money for those times where you're actually having a good time with your friends and enjoying a social meal? A real food snack is actually faster than grabbing takeout or even ordering fast food. Just think about it. You just pop it out of your bag and enjoy it right in the middle of whatever you're doing. So here's my go-to zero prep real food snack. I mix some almonds, Brazil nuts, and cashews, and throw in some cranberries, and mix it all in a resealable bag. I keep this in my bag wherever I go, and if I'm looking for a hot kick, I add some chili, kale chips, and wasabi soybeans in there as well. It's ready in minutes and requires virtually zero prep, and I even often fill up a large resealable jar that keeps hunger at bay for the rest of the week. After 3 p.m., I simply grab a few handful of these for a dense, focus-boosting nutrient bomb. And I'm getting the high-quality protein, the brain-feeding fats, the focus-boosting electrolytes, and an added afternoon motivation boost. Problem solved. Time saved. This probably saves me like 45 minutes because there's no need to order or hunt and wait for and munch on worse options. In the next video, I will explain why eating the right nutrients isn't enough to improve health and why most people suffer from gut issues at some point in their life. I would love to hear your go-to recipes for beating hunger, so share them in the comments below. I would love to try them out myself too. Talk to you soon.